Life. Ladies and gentlemen, members of the media, of course, and all of you joining us live across the world via webcast, welcome to this, the official FIFA World Cup 2010 match ball handover. And what an electric excitement there is. I think you cannot watch the disky dances and not want to jika jika kama dikrit. Yakwas, how many Africans in the room here? Oh, I love it. The world really is watching South Africa. So it's amazing to see so many from so many different countries here with us celebrating the beautiful game. Now, my name is Joanne Strauss, and I'm very proud today to be South African, to be African, but first and foremost, to be a football fan. And it really is awesome to see all these faces here. Now, ladies and gentlemen, manene no manene kazwamkele kile apa kuzakubaku manikrit. Uyakwas. When I say that, ladies and gentlemen, though you may not understand when I speak Xhosa, when we speak football, we all speak a universal language. And I think that is what binds us, each and every one of us, from across the continent, across the globe. We are all binded in the name of football. So, ladies and gentlemen, if we think about the passion and that what makes football this absolute spectacle to watch, of course, we know the passion has to be combined with technology. Now, passion and technology, Adidas does that perfectly. So to welcome you all, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the CEO, Mr. Herbert Heine. Good to have you here. Now, Mr. Heine, this is not your first visit to Cape Town. Tell me, you've been here a couple of times.
No, of course not. I guess it's 15 years ago that I came first to Cape Town when I got the responsibility within Adidas for Europe and Africa. And since then, I can't count it anymore how often I have been here.
Officially, we'll give you residency of Cape Town because it is a wonderful city to visit.
It is.
Now tell me, next year South Africa will take center stage at the World Cup. What does the World Cup mean to Adidas?
I mean, first and foremost, football is the heart and soul of our company, there is no doubt. And the World Cup is the best platform to show this. This is where the best meets the best. And here to show our products and show what our company is able to do, there is no better opportunity.
Fantastic. Now, how much Adidas will we see at the World Cup? Take me through that.
Oh, I guess you can't miss us. First and foremost, we are the official partner of the FIFA. This means we are outfitting all the referees, the ball boys, the volunteers. Then we have, and you, of course.
Of course.
Then we have 12 of the 32 teams which we are outfitting, and we are pleased that Bafana, the home nation, is outfitted by us as well. We have over 100 players, including David Beckham, he is here today, and of course we have the official match ball.
Fantastic, so lots and lots of brand visibility. And then tell me also, what makes the match ball so important to you from Adidas?
But this is a complete new ball. First and foremost, it's a technological revolution, completely new constructed. This is the most accurate ball which we have ever made. And secondly, I think the ball looks fabulous. The design, in my opinion, is great. It reflects what this country is all about, the colorfulness, the joy. And I'm quite excited, and I guess most of you will be here really positively surprised how good the ball is.
Fantastic. I like that. It looks good and it works well, pretty much like the gentleman in front, but we won't delve into that. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I think when we think about football, we also think about the proud history. Now, if you know where you're going to, you have to know where you're coming from, and that's very, very important. So I think it's been for the past 40 years that you've been making the ball for the World Cup. Let's have a look at the proud history. I've literally got goosebumps when I think about what this is going to mean to South Africa and to all of us here to welcome you and to just experience all the passion of this game. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we spoke about history. I'm about to welcome onto stage one of the greatest footballers of all time, Mr. Franz Beckenbauer, or Der Kaiser, as he's affectionately known, is the only one to have ever lifted the World Cup trophy, both as a player and as a coach. He's made history in so many different ways, ladies and gentlemen. He's a fantastic leader. He's also led Germany's World Cup bid, and then, of course, the very successful World Cup we had in 2006 in Germany. So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, Mr. Franz Beckenbauer. Lovely honor.
Thank you.
Herzlich willkommen in meiner wunderschöne Heimatstadt.
Dankeschön, danke.
I've been trying a little bit.
Für mich einer der schönsten Städte der Welt.
Ah, vielen, vielen Dank, vielen Dank. Lovely to hear that. He says it's one of the loveliest cities for him, so it's lovely to have Mr. Beckenbauer here. I think that does deserve a huge round of applause. Vielen Dank. Now, Mr. Beckenbauer, how has the football developed from your active career until now? I mean, you've seen a lot.
Yeah, I think it's very simple to answer. Just watch the television. Between the first World Cup I played was 1966. I watched a game on television from 1966. And now it's a different speed. It's a different... It's everything is different. Even the ball is different. You know, when we started to play in the 40s and in the 50s, there was a leather ball. It should be a leather ball, but we are miles away from talking about a leather ball. It's I don't know, the material comes from the moon or from the Mars or from somewhere. So it's a complete different game. The players are running faster. It's more athletic. But it's the development of the game.
Absolutely. I think it's also true. I think in those days we came from black and white television. Now we're watching in HD. So it is quite a transformation. Tell me, there's a new match ball presented here today. What do you think when you remember also the products from the past and you compare it to the products of today?
Yeah, I think I answered this question already. It's a big difference. You know, the leather ball, you know, at the first World Cup in England or also in Mexico, you know, it was a leather ball when the pitch was wet. So, you know, the ball gets heavier and heavier. And then sometimes, you know, if you try to score a goal from 20 meters, you know, you pull the muscle because the ball was so heavy. Or you made a head ball, you know, then you got, a little bit.
Concussion.
Yeah. But that's part of the game. It's been changed already.
Fantastic. I can't wait to see exactly how we're all going to perform with this new ball. Now, of course, from Germany to South Africa, Germans are well known for their precision, and we had a wonderful World Cup, of course, in 2006. Now we're here in South Africa. How do you think it's going to differ?
I think it's going to be the same World Cup. The fans are coming there. It's a beautiful country, one of the most beautiful countries in the world. I'm witness because the first time I came to the country was 25 years ago, not to see a football game or whatever, so to play golf. After I finished my career as a player, I started to play golf, and it's a paradise. Paradise. Yes. This Cape Town area, it's a paradise to play golf. So for me, it's one of the beautiful countries in the world. And the fans... I was here in July, during the Confederation Cup. It was a fantastic atmosphere. Also, Mr. President, the vuvuzelas, it belongs to Africa. It's a part of the African culture. So why not? David, you have to bring some, when you're on the field, you have to bring some, because it's very noisy, I tell you. I think it's going to be a great, great World Cup. Danny and his friends and teammates, we know each other for more than a decade, because South Africa was also running for the World Cup 2006. So we are almost a family, and I wish him and your teammates all the best and all the success we had in Germany. So I am convinced it's going to be a wonderful World Cup.
Fantastic. Lovely to hear. Mr. Franz Beckenbauer, thank you so much for your time. Ladies and gentlemen, Der Kaiser, vielen Dank nochmal. Wow. really a lot of history. If we think about it, I didn't quite think of the leather ball and how it would get water, etc. But yes, it has come a long, long way, ladies and gentlemen. But we've had enough talk about this, and we know how women love to talk. They say there are three forms of communication: television, telephone, telewoman. I won't speak much more, ladies and gentlemen. Now it's time for you to see the official FIFA World Cup match ball. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, JABULANI. And I think in our language, that means to celebrate. And that's exactly what we're going to be doing, is celebrating the beautiful game. Now, you can imagine how much work, how much research goes into the production of a ball that pretty much becomes the focal point of billions and billions of football fans from all over the world. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's have a look at exactly what went into producing JABULANI.
C'est un bon ballon, un super ballon, avec de belles couleurs.
Des couleurs africaines qui ressemblent beaucoup à notre continent.
JABULANI, celebrate diversity at FIFA World Cup.
JABULANI, celebrate Africa.
Nowadays, football stands for a very athletic and very fast game. So what the player needs is precision.
If you have a good ball and they fly this direction, like you want, you have a great chance to score.
Kitchen up.
Looking back through the last World Cups, we've gone from 32 panels to 14 panels to now only 8 panels.
Pretty good.
In a traditional ball, the two-dimensional flat panels need to be distorted when the ball is inflated. But we start with three-dimensional panels, and when we inflate the ball, we get a perfect round ball.
Perfect. It's nice to play with.
This is important as well because it means the stiffness of the ball is the same wherever you kick it.
J'espère marquer beaucoup de buts et c'est un ballon qui donne envie à tirer, à shooter, à faire beaucoup de choses.
We had invented a complete, entirely new way of production. We are now entering into industrial production process, automated processes that allow us to make perfect parts. And from those perfectly made parts, we can then achieve the perfect ball. This robot can kick the ball identically, time and time and time again. And that's really important in our research, that we can give the ball the same kick a number of times, vary the position to check that the same accuracy is achieved from all over the ball.
First ball is comfortable with the touching. Now it's a good ball to score a goal.
You can feel the energy going through the ball. When you catch the ball, you can actually feel the power which is inside of the ball. First, when I saw the ball, I saw a very nice looking ball. But if it's gonna be disturbing much when it flies, I would say no, because the white is really dominant.
This is the first aerodynamically engineered soccer ball. For over 6 years, we've been working in the wind tunnel to understand the complex aerodynamics around soccer balls. On the center of the panel, we have these aero grooves. In fact, we spent a lot of our time in the wind tunnel thinking about these aero grooves. Where should they be placed? What is the geometry that they should have?
I'm very impressed with the way that Adidas has approached designing the new match ball. They've taken a lot of the research results from wind tunnel testing and analytical analysis and worked on the optimization of the aero grooves and the surface of the ball to optimize and minimize the influence of the air on the ball.
I have a feeling that the ball um Fuß geht und dann katapultiert wird. Gezielt.
And I like the texture to the outside, which I hope is going to help with a bit of movement on the ball and swerve, which it seems to do already.
Grip and groove is a term we've used to describe the main technologies on the ball. Grip is used really to describe the surface texture that we have over the ball, which makes sure we have consistent playing conditions in the wet and the dry. Players will have confidence to kick this ball in all conditions.
Also, er macht das, was du eigentlich willst, und gibt's wenig Ausreden.
Really incredible, ladies and gentlemen. What do you think of JABULANI? Are you liking her? Now, next up, we have a football player who has scored in 3 consecutive World Cups. There's not a lot of footballers who have actually managed to do that. In fact, I think when I think of his name, even people who have never seen a football match has heard of him. So I think you might have a clue as to who's going to come up right now, ladies and gentlemen. He's captained the English team, of course. He's also had the pleasure of testing our new JABULANI match ball. Without any further ado, please welcome Mr. David Beckham. Mr. David Beckham, welcome. I think we are exceptionally happy to have you on our shores. What has Cape Town been like for you thus far?
It's the first time I've visited here. I've been other places in Africa, and I've always had an amazing welcome. Really, the people are so warm, and they really are amazing people, not just in sport world, but in life. So it's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for the welcome. But it's just amazing to be here.
Wonderful. Now, you've had the pleasure of testing JABULANI, am I right?
Yes, I have.
Any initial comments?
Well, to me, Adidas are the biggest and best sports brand in the world. Of course, I'm biased, but it's also true. And of course, I've had a great relationship with Adidas for many, many years, and I've tested a few soccer balls over the years, and without doubt, technology, they're number one. Style, they're number one. And they always produce the best balls in the world. And this is another one. It represents, the color represents the country. of Africa, and I think it's very special because the colours are bright and it's attractive. And as a football player, of course, it's the tools of our trade and we want the best. And any good football player will be able to control any ball, but it's good to have a little bit of help, and Adidas give us more than that.
Fantastic. Now, tell me also, you've played at a couple of World Cups, right? What do you expect from the ball? I mean, I think you've pretty much answered that as well, but just what do you expect from the ball? Perfect control?
Well, you want it to, the flight of it has to be perfect, mm-hmm. of course. For my personal game, accuracy is always important. For outfield players, you want that movement. For goalkeepers, for me, it's not that important because I'm not a goalkeeper. So we want it to move as much as possible. But like I said, technology, Adidas are the best. And again, they've made an amazing ball.
Well, you've said this. I mean, you have seen so many footballs. Do you still get excited when you see a new ball and a new concept like JABULANI?
I really do. I've been like that since I was a kid. I've always wanted to be a football player. And every Christmas, that's all I ever asked for was a football.
So I've got my Christmas list for you sorted out, huh? You want this?
Of course. And Father Christmas always used to bring me one. So I was very lucky. But yeah, of course, I always get excited about even new boots or new balls that come out. And I always have the pleasure of testing them. So this one's a very good one.
Fantastic. Mr. David Beckham, thank you so much for joining us. Ladies and gentlemen, David Beckham.
Thank you.
I like that. We're all getting very excited, and of course we're seeing how the tension is building up to 2010, ladies and gentlemen. Now, the man at the helm of all of this, two men actually, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to welcome the president of FIFA, Mr. Joseph Blatter, and of course the CEO of the 2010 FIFA World Cup in South Africa, Dr. Danny Jordan. Gentlemen, please join me on stage.